again. It's Joevin Jones with a positive run. It's a wonderful finish.
This Saturday evening, I have the privilege of being joined by the two of Trinidad and Tobago's premier overseas-based professional players, Kevin Molino and Joevin Jones. What a privilege it is to have you guys here. On the weekend, leading up to probably one of the biggest games in your careers, both of you in the American Major League Soccer, both Minnesota United and Seattle Sounders clash in the MLS Western Conference Final. Gentlemen, thank you for taking the time out and being here with us today.
My pleasure, Sean.
It's a pleasure to be here.
All right. I don't know who to start with because, I mean, this is like, you know, something is historical in many ways. Both men coming from Carnage, Hague Street, Kevin Molino, Joevin, you yourself, you know, your brother Alvin June has been in the MLS as well. And you all have continued to fly the flag, continue to carry our national colors and having an opportunity now to battle each other on the same field of play. Kevin, before you started your career in the MLS, would you have ever foreseen this opportunity coming up in terms of being able to go up against probably your best friend on in such an important game?
No given day, I'd predict this would happen. But it's God work, and looking forward to the game. On the day, we are the underdog. We have two wins already, and looking forward to the game. But more important is a win-win situation for Trinidad, Carnage, the community, to uplift the communities, you know, under a really, really difficult time we have been through as a people, Trinidad football and whatnot. So we just want to inspire and show that we have this light still to shine on Trinidad football.
Joevin, how you feel about it? He's saying that his team is the underdogs. Obviously, you guys have history. You know what it takes to win a MLS Cup title. What do you feel about that?
I think we are confident as a team, you know, going into this final. You know, we have the experience. The guys who've been there last year, you know, it felt like to be in a final. As you said, they are the underdogs and we're defending the crown, you know. So it's experience for both teams, and it's in the making to make history as players and as clubs as well. You know, it's an honor to share the same pitch with Molino, you know. I think it's a big showing for our country and our communities.
Tell me something, Joevin, and Kevin, I'll come back to you on this. I know for a fact when you all are in camp together, you discuss game tactics, you discuss your mood, mental preparation, etc. And even now, out there in the MLS, sometimes you all bounce things off each other before you go into to face another team. So, for instance, Kevin, before the game against Sporting Kansas, I'm sure you and Joevin would have been talking, but now it's a different scenario. What is the conversation? What is the connection, communication going to be like over the next 48 hours?
I think it's the same, you know, like every night we speak like for hours on life, different processes of on life on the whole and different things and football, you know, and the community and also what's going on in our country as well.
Nothing about what went on a training pitch.
Nazia.
Yeah, Kevin, your take on that in terms of, you know, How are you all able to, I shouldn't say cope, because it is natural. You all have a certain level of relationship, a certain level of respect for each other, and you all are professionals. So what is that process going to be like over the next 48 hours before this game on Monday?
In life, friendship is more important than anything. You know, friendship go on for a lifetime. Football is short, and our friendship not going to change because of the competition or what at stake for the both teams. You know, our friendship is for lifetime, and it's an honor and a pleasure to be on the same park with him. He went to championship, and the best team will win on the day. And as I said, is Trinidad going to win on the day? Carina is going to win benefit, and we just want to have a good showing, and on the day, the best team win.
Kevin, looking at you in particular, you know, this season has been really something for you in terms of what you've had to go through coming back from injury, you rehab, and you caught yourself again and out again because of injury, and now you've been able to pick back up and really lead this Minnesota United team with your performances in, over the last few weeks. And all of this in the midst of a pandemic, which has been a season like none other for any professional footballer. Go through that for us.
This is it's something you want to enjoy. You know, I don't think this will ever happen in football ever again in history of football. Hopefully not. But I put in the work. It's no surprise with the help of my teammates, family, friends, Joevin. I do a lot of training with Joevin through COVID, you know, and he helped me a lot also, and I help him. And, you know, it's just God work, and I just want to continue to do what I do best, contribute to the team, make and score a goal, and stay humble and see where the next couple of days can take me and Joevin.
Joevin, I saw the videos, and we would have interacted during that period when you were having those training sessions, personal training sessions with Kevin during the COVID. And who would have thought back then that you all would be preparing for such a game? Because when you look at it, at that point in time, you were preparing for what is happening on Monday. Would you have wanted any other way?
No, this is the perfect way. As we said before, it's a great showing for our country and community, you know. It's a blessing, I can say.
Tell us about, you know, the mood in the Seattle camp now. Obviously, you guys know what it takes to lift the MLS Cup. Is Minnesota United really being viewed as one of the underdog teams in the MLS this season? How is the team preparing for something like this?
I think we are preparing very well. Also, we are not watching them lightly, because if you watch their past few games, they've been scoring goals and they've been fluid. So it's a team you have to be careful with, and you have to focus throughout the 90 minutes.
I think when you look at the head-to-head, you all have won the last three encounters, and generally you've won 7 matches. Minnesota have won 3. But this game, as of now, is the most important game in the history of the two clubs.
It's a final. Yeah, it's a final, you know. And if you watch the past few games, it wasn't like a big difference. It was like close games, you know. And this is the finals, you know. Much guys will be excited and pumped to win a trophy with the club for the first time. And I think Minnesota, they had an up and down year, sure, the COVID and also the death of George Floyd. So they're going to be motivated by that and to bring back something to the city.
Kevin, what's it like now, obviously, with you and Dane Sinclair? Obviously, he's eligible for representing Trinidad and Tobago as well. And he has been a pillar for the team, especially in the last game. You know, when you look at the game itself, Kansas, they had the best of the stats. What is the camaraderie between you and him in terms of preparing for such a game, and knowing that, you know, you have that relationship with Joevin? He would know who Joevin is as well. But how do you all bounce things off each other?
Oh, no, we share ideas. That's the good thing about sports. You know, you feed off of one another, you share ideas, and you share knowledge at where you have been in the past and how Joevin play in Seattle. So it's just a matter of time. Just we preparing as a team, not just me and Dane Sinclair, but the whole group, going into final with a lot of emotions. As Joevin rightfully said, the stuff that happened with Floyd and all the things that we've been through, you know, as a team collectively, is we just want to go there and give our best shot. But Dane Sinclair could represent Trinidad. Hopefully he take it on board and represent us, because it's going to be a big boost for us, national team. So we just need to hope for the best and hope he come on board.
As you mentioned, the national team there, tell us a bit about the fact that the World Cup qualifying schedule was released yesterday. So we know that we're at home to Guyana in the first game on March 25th. Are you looking forward now to getting over the season, hopefully on the best note possible, and coming back home and getting in a few sessions with the boys ahead of next year?
I have to wait and see how I feel after the season. It has been long. It has been draining mentally. Yeah. But I want to keep training. I want to keep the form. I don't want to drop my barrier, go home for a couple of time and don't train. I want to keep grinding, keep going. But in terms of national team, I want to take my foot off the gas a bit and do a little bit of thinking where I really want to be. Where is my next move? I think this is important. I'm a free agent next couple of weeks. So this is the thing I have to think about. And national team, when the opportunity comes to me, I will decide to the best of my ability.
Right. Joevin, obviously, you've been away for quite some time from home. Long season, challenging season. And again, a lot of football to look forward to in 2021.
Yeah, no, it feels like we had three preseason this season here. You know, it's been a roller coaster year, you know. And with the national team, you know, I always look forward to go and represent. You know, as a kid, I always wanted that and to follow my dream and my goals for the national team. But as Kevin said, his situation is different. You know, you have to wait. He's a free agent. You know, he don't want anything to happen to him. You know, you have to seek his future because we are in our prime right now and we have to make the right choice at this moment.
Kevin, what can we expect? I mean, obviously, you don't want to give away too much, but the game on Monday, I think is going to be a closely contested one. But if you look at that, how the season has gone in Major League Soccer, sometimes you get the total opposite of what you're anticipating. One team might be able to pull away from the other within 30 minutes of the match and game is over. But this particular...
Sure.
I don't know if that's a signal from Joevin as to what Minnesota should expect. But what are you looking forward to in terms of what do you anticipate?
Sean, the team with the right mentality and the right attitude going to win on the day. Skill, it's going to have loads of ability on the field, you know, but mentally 90% of, out of 100, 90% is mental. And the team that mentally strong going to win on the day. And in football, the little details matters the most. So the team with the give up the less chances have opportunity to win. But the team with the most mentally prepared and disciplined not to make less mistakes as possible going to win the game. And hopefully it's us.
Joevin, you share the same sentiments? Or you really feel that this time around, I think Seattle is going to show out there?
For sure, you know, we at home, you know, we find many ways to win games at home. You know, it mightn't be the prettiest of games, but we always find a way to win. The game on Monday, I think it's not going to be an easy game. It's going to be a tough game. But as Kevin said, the team with the less mistakes is going to win the game, you know. I think the team, you know, not much guys has been in this situation like Seattle, you know, because most of the guys throughout the 4 or 5 years, they've been in 3-4 Western finals. And I think they know what it felt like to be there and the pressure they have to deal with.
When you look at the other conference, Columbus Crew, New England Revolution as well, they've had decent seasons and they've showed that it could be anybody's title. How do you assess that conference?
Yeah, I think they had a solid season, to be honest. You know, they had more points than us. Well, Columbus had more points than us. So hopefully tomorrow we train for New England to win so the finals can be in Seattle.
And Kevin, an opportunity again for you all to really prove the doubters wrong, because a lot of people are saying that it's been a good fairy tale run for Minnesota United, but you all want to prove that you belong there.
We want to prove, but we have nothing to lose. All we can do is go out and give our best shot. You know, we're in this position because we work hard together as a team with a little brilliance from different players. But Sean, on the day we can talk all we talk now, but on the day your boots have to do the talking. The team who go out and perform gonna win and advance.
Gentlemen, when you look at the fact that, you know, what you all have done as two Trinidadian, two professional players from Trinidad and Tobago, what you've come from, and there are a lot of players searching for that opportunity. They are hoping to have a better year ahead because 2020 has been very difficult for a lot of us. I'm seeing some of the local players are training here under Terry Fenwick, and you can see that they're eager and they're really showing that desire, but it's been a very challenging year for them. You guys are representing them out there. What do you have to say to either of the players who are in the squad right now in terms of being able to keep pushing and trying to achieve something?
I think it will be a motivation for them. Also, everyone had a long year. You know, it's no excuses. It's just to hold the pressure and do the right things and hold firm and never give up, you know.
Kevin, what's your response?
Yeah, Sean, I think this is the perfect moment. You know, we all could do good when everything is nice and you scoring goals and do all sort of things. You can do good things. But when the pressure is on, you could hold strain, go out there, work hard, sacrifice. If it means sacrificing everything to get something, it means that way. And now is the perfect time as footballers or business or whatever you do in life. Now is the time to succeed, to show that people that you mentally can deal with anything come your way. And as the young players back home, they have to work harder. They have to sacrifice. They have to give up things to be with where they want to be in their future, you know, and work on their mental side of the game.
Joevin, you've had an opportunity as well to succeed at this level. You had a stint in Germany. You ended up back in Seattle, and you've showed that sort of persistence to overcome challenges. What do you have to say to the people of Carnage and also to the rest of the country?
I think it's an honor, you know, to be on this big stage to represent my community and the country, you know. I think much guys on the whole, like, not even Trinidadians, like, around the world, you know, don't get this feeling to be in a final, because most players, they play throughout their career and they never end up in a finals or get a chance to lift a trophy, you know. So it's an honor to be here once again, and we just have to keep on going and flying our country flag high.
Gentlemen, I know one of you will have to be back on the early flight. The repatriation flight back to Trinidad come next week. I can't say who I would prefer because I...
What do you mean you can't say? You know already. You know.
So I want to take this opportunity on behalf of the country and behalf of the Trinidad and Tobago Football Association to wish you all the very best. We hope you come through the game as in flying colors, safe, fit, fully fit, no injuries, and what can I say? May the best man and may the best team win on Monday and go all the way. Thank you for this opportunity and all the best to both of you.
Sure.
Thank you.
All right, bro. All right, cool. All right. Thanks, bro. Take care.